She had her first episode when she was 2. It was a quick diagnosis as to her allergies, dairy and eggs. Living with that diagnosis was confusing and scary because we were never quite sure when something was going to happen.
She loved art. She loved music. She loved plays. She loved sports. You know, she was so involved in her life, and it was just that's what made it so incredibly hard for us was that she was a wow.
When Isaac was first diagnosed at 1 year old, he was found to have severe allergies to milk, to eggs, to peanuts, and to tree nuts. It began a life of a different kind of life, suddenly terrifying. Never thinking that a little couple of bites of French toast could cause you to have to rush your child in an ambulance to the hospital.
Food allergies have risen dramatically in the last 20 years. 20 years ago, it was 1%, maybe 2%. Now, in the most recent studies, it's seeing us up to at least 6%, if possibly even higher.
Ezra had just turned 11 when he passed away. When somebody dies, they say, "Where, you know, what do you want to do with donations?" So we said we would like the money to be channeled to food allergy. Because of his death, we were able to completely change our family's quality of life, and especially his brother.
The treatments for food allergies have been completely revolutionized in the past 2 or 3 years. It's really one of the most transformative things I've seen, and I've been here for 20 years.
Patients like Isaac are heroes. In order to be in a study, you actually need to eat the food that you're allergic to. So they have this reaction, they get really sick, they probably get medicine. Again, this needs to be done at a place like Children's Hospital where we're able to treat a reaction.
We have to trick your body or reteach your body that these once harmful things, what body thought was harmful, is not really harmful.
Food allergies can actually kill a child. That is what I fear the most.
She ate really fast that night. She wolfed down her food. There were so many kids there, and she was so excited and so happy.
You know, it was a pickle and a piece of chicken and a piece of bread and some juice.
It was probably the juice that she drank, and they don't flush the machines through as carefully as would need to be flushed through for somebody as sensitive as her.
The incident was, you know, like a rattlesnake bitter. It was 100 times worse than anything that she had ever experienced.
What we wanted to do was to, in some way, make some meaning out of her death and honor her life. To hear about kids go through these studies and come out being able to tolerate what they're allergic to, have it every day, which is something that we want for other kids so that nobody goes through what our daughter had to go through.
There's a light at the end of the tunnel. There will be success in this. We can accelerate that by getting the money to the researchers and to the labs and have continued great results.
This is one disease that they can fix. There's so many other diseases that maybe they don't have any clue, or they've maybe scraped the surface, but with food allergies, they have gone so deep, and they can fix it. They can fix it. So if they just have enough money to fund more studies, it'll be a different world.
It was really amazing when I could see that I could eat something that everybody else could eat.
We used to not really have a treatment. The treatment was really the families and the children had to avoid the food. And now there's actually hope. We're just at the edge of all of these amazing discoveries and really being able to take children's lives and improve them on a very large scale. It's tremendously exciting, but we can't do it without philanthropy.
Having hope changes your life and changes your viewpoint. I get calls and parents call me up all the time, like, what can I do? Is anything out there I can help save my child so he doesn't have this anymore? If you asked me 10 years ago, I would have said there's nothing. But now I can tell you there is hope.
I want to thank Chuck for giving me the opportunity to take part in these studies. It has made everything in my life easier, from going out to eat to seeing my friends.
I don't have to worry that much anymore about coming in contact with peanuts and having an allergic reaction.
Not having to worry about food allergies is so great, and no more trips to the hospital.
It has changed my life completely because I can go out to restaurants with friends. I can go to ice cream parlors.
Hi, I'm Alexis. Thanks to Chuck, I can now eat peanut butter. Bye.
I was at sleepaway camp, and there was a kid who had birthday cake and I had it. It was really good.